A great big jumbo hello to you, my Minecraft friend. Welcome back to another episode of Life in the Woods Renaissance here at the GEI. I am the Radio Man 03, and it is awesome to have you along. I did it. It's done. The earth is in, the torches are torched, and we're ready to move forward out here. We are. I've got it all done today. I've spent 2 hours today. 2 hours? What did I just push? I just pushed F8. I don't know what that does, but hopefully it's nothing bad. Aha! It gives you the grid of the chunks. That's what it does. Okay. So it's all greened up. I removed... Okay. All right. Let me try this again. Okay. I removed all the stone from here and put in grass. I think it looks good. I left this stone right up here against the GEI walkway. I left that stone there, but the rest of this is grassed in. I want you to look at it. Look at it. Look at it in all its green, glorious beauty. All the way down, even this little hillside right here, I've got almost completely patched in. A little bit of stone showing right there. I did not cover up the stone down here. I didn't do it. A little bit of stone on the mountain range is going to be good. And it's way down here, so it's really not going to be all that visible to us at all. And let's come over here. I believe we can look, actually look in this way. We can. There's torches going way back in here underneath this hillside. So we're good to go there as well. Am I hearing footsteps? It was just night. I had not been sleeping. Yeah, so I was kind of I'm kind of worried about that. You know what? I think we could probably use a few torches right down in here. Yeah, look at this. Boom. Tons of torches back in there. So that's all lit up now. I don't think we have to worry about mobs spawning down there. You know, odds are I probably missed a spot or two, and we will have some mobs show up. But for the most part, I think we're good to go with this right here, and we are ready to move forward. Is this going to green up with some grass? I don't think so, not with these guys right here. We need to get this over. Well, you know what? It's grassless dirt. It's just too cold for it right over here. It doesn't like it. We could, though. You know what? Actually, let's do that. Let's get it greened up. There we go. That should spread over to that direction. All right, so that's all taken care of there, and we're good to go all the way down. And like I said, I want to clear out a chunk of this right here and turn this into our tree farm area where we're going to grow our birch and our oaks for just whatever we want to use them for. It's kind of the, you know, those two trees, I don't care for them too much, so I just kind of use those for the sticks and for carpenter blocks and things like that. We did have an ukali tree pop up. Was it ukali? I'm not quite sure. But anyways, we've had some more trees pop up. Hello, everybody. Hello. We're almost to you guys. I swear. Next few episodes, we're going to be moving you guys. Uh-huh. Yep, you're all going to have your own space. You're going to have your own space. I was going to remove all the trees today, but I thought, nah, we did quite a bit of grindy grind work in the last episode labeled dirt. And so this episode, what we're going to do is we are going to kind of further the shoreline around the mountain lake. I thought that would be kind of fun to do. The Unukali, yeah, Unukali tree popped up. I don't know where the sapling was, but obviously it was on the ground, and here it is. It must have been, well, obviously right down there. It had trouble starting because it didn't have enough space, but eventually it said, oh yeah, Radio, I can grow here. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do it, as a matter of fact. Now, some of you really, really love the willow tree. And I can't argue that. The willow tree is gorgeous. I had a lot of suggestions come in from the last episode. And one thing was, is you do want to see a pond out here. So we will turn this into a pond. I can guarantee you that. Let's go ahead and we're going to actually do this. And we're going to drop that wood for just a second. And we are going to go ahead and plant ourselves a willow tree right here. Okay? There we go. We're going to have ourselves a willow tree down here. I believe we're far enough down in elevation that this is going to be just fine. Do I have... Well, I was just looking in there. I don't have any bone meal actually on me. Let's get some of this going, and let's get some bone meal. We've got compost on us. We can always get some more of that. And we're going to take these guys up here and do that like so. And there we go. A willow tree. It's a big one, too. Holy cow, it's a big willow tree. Anyways, there we go. We've got a willow going. So just so you know, we are going to turn this into a pond up here. I think it's a good idea, okay? Another suggestion when we get time to build the... it's time to build the villager's village was to have a boardwalk along here. And that sounds pretty cool. I think that sounds pretty darn cool. A boardwalk right along here. And then the villagers can move back and forth on here. Mobs won't be able to get to them from in the water. Hopefully the villagers won't get in the water. I guess we could rail the boardwalk so they can't get out. We'll make it so the villagers are safe. We will do our best to make sure they're safe. Oh, there's some XP sitting there waiting for us. Let's go kill them. So that was another suggestion. We want that piece. We want that wood. Let's put the bone meal away. There we go. And let's put that back, and we'll take the bone meal back. There we go. Beautiful. So there we go. A willow tree. A great big jumbo willow tree. Beautiful. And then there was a suggestion for... Oh, hello. Hi there. Yeah, you're going to die now, you fool. Let's see. Here we go. Pesky spider. Why would he even come after me? That's kind of weird, I think. We're going to drop the spider eye, grab the string. Was it just the one string? It's just the one string, huh? That's okay. We'll take it. Was a lookout tower and a silo. Every good farm has a silo, was the comment. And I can't argue that. I think right over in this general area here, we're going to do that. I think we'll do kind of a combination of the two, a silo and a lookout tower, someplace that we can get on top of and look around. But I think mostly what this is going to be is just a beacon of your almost home. And we'll probably put it right about here. So as we come back from that village that lies way over there, we're going to see it first, this structure right here, and we're going to know we're almost home. So maybe we'll do something like that right here. The pond is over there. And then, of course, we talked about already that we're going to have our farmland stretch out this way. You can see I've grassed in a little bit of this as well. We do still have this little pond right here that I may leave just because. And then right here we had several openings with water in it that I kept falling into as I ran back and forth here, especially at night running from mobs. So I filled those in as well. So now we have just this nice palette of green grass and stuff. I left this alone because I'm going to have to come in here on my own at some point in time and take all this marble out and replace it with dirt. And that's why we've not done anything with this over here. Look at that. You can see Lavender Field way over there. Beautiful, huh? Just gorgeous. So I think I will spend a time... myself chopping down this tree here and all these trees right in this area and this one and that one so that we've got a really clean palette to just kind of gaze across the land and kind of idea where we're going to put everything. And then I think what we'll do is we'll start with paths. We'll get the paths installed and then we'll move on from there. Strawberries. Oh yeah. I think it was Vessi who reminded me that plant mega pack. Those are the plants that you can multiply over and over again. So that's what I did with some of these really cool things. So we're going to revisit, first of all, the area we've already taken care of. And we're going to get some of these ferns and stuff going in here. Let's see. Oh, and blueberry bushes, too. Yes, blueberry bushes. I wanted to add a little bit of color back in here. Let's do a blueberry bush. Well, that's not where I wanted you, darling. There you go, right there. A little blueberry bush right there. And we'll put a blueberry bush. Let's put one right here. Okay, we're going to spread them out. I think it would be kind of cool as if we walk across the landscape that we can kind of munch on things. Just have a variety of foods available to us. That's enough of those. Let's go ahead and do a few of these little green ferns here. There we go. Perfect. Like, just like that. Oh, the sun is going down. Dang it. I just got started here, people. We just got started, I should say. Can I put these on here? Oh, beautiful. Awesome. Love that. Yeah, there we go. Just some growths that came on to the plants, you know? Something like that. Here's a bed. We could just sleep right here. Sun goes down. I brought a furnace out. I've been cooking potatoes. Yeah, I know. I'm being lazy about the cooking thing, but I brought a furnace out. It's right over there, and I've been just eating the potatoes and the strawberries and stuff like that. But that's kind of my goal, is to actually be able to walk through the property, and if we don't have food on us, we can just pick stuff. You know, we'll have blueberries right there, and let's put another blueberry bush right. Let's put a blueberry bush right there. That looks good to me. And how about a fern or two right there? Not right there, right there. We'll put another fern right here. And we've got several different kinds of ferns. A boxwood, there we go. And I wanted one of these guys here too. These guys are pretty cool. This is a nice little, what is this called? This is the cylindrical cedar. And I'm going to put one of these guys right here, I think. Where's the axe at? There's the axe. I need the bone meal back, please. Oh, now I did it. And what don't we need in our inventory right now? We don't need the silk touch pick. Let's put that over there, and then we'll be good to go. Let's get this guy grown up. There we go. See, it's just a little tiny... Well, is this plant mega pack? It is plant mega pack. Let's get a few of these going. Let's get a few of these guys. These guys are going to be the nice little bushes that are going to just kind of tuck in. You know what I mean? They're going to tuck into places that you may need a little something going. There we go. Just like that, you see? Now when we look through here, there's a little bit of green down low here as well. And let's put another one right back in here. There we go. Beautiful. Maybe I shouldn't be using the bone meal too much. We don't really have a lot. Until we get our mob grinder going, we're not going to have a lot to play with. All right, so now I want a white cherry. We've got some good green and stuff going on here, but I want a white cherry sapling. And we're going to put her right out front here. Bold and beautiful and big and cherry-like, okay? So now we've got even a little bit of pink going on in here. That's very nice. We're going to throw another little bush right down in here. And let's bone meal this grass. Bam. Oh, look at the flowers that popped up. Lovely. Awesome. Okay, and then back here we want some of our taller trees. And I've got one of these yellow ones here. And this time we are not going to shrink it. We are going to let this one go. And we're going to give it some room so it can be in all of its glory. Maybe that piece of dirt's blocking it. There it goes. There it goes. Beautiful. All right, and we want the dirt back down here. Let's see how she looks. Oh, she's just a little tiny thing, isn't she? Okay, I thought she was going to be much bigger than that. It's okay. And a blueberry bush. Blueberry bushes like it in the cold. So we're going to make sure that they have plenty of cold weather here for them to grow properly. And let's find another type of fern. Here we go. Here's a classic Minecraft fern right here. Let's throw a few of these in here. Let's splash these guys around a little bit. There we go. And we can take that out of there now. And then we've got a Japanese maple. But let's get a few classic Minecraft spruce going as well. Let's drop you right about here and have you pop up in front of these guys. Oop. There we go. Just like so. Tuck that yellow. Oh, it kind of really hides the yellow, doesn't it? It really does hide that yellow tree. Okay, yeah, I don't like the way that one came up. Let's move that. Gonna let them despawn on their own. If I use the scythe on these guys, I have a feeling that they're going to cause... they're gonna break other... You know, the leaves from the other trees are gonna come off, so we don't want to do that. We'll just make sure it's not touching the cherry, and then it should despawn just fine. Yeah, okay, let's just leave that alone. We'll take that resin. What can I get out of my inventory? The workbench. There we go. Boom. And there we go. And I even multiplied the twigs, believe it or not. The twigs. These little tiny twigs. Can you believe it? Yeah, just little twigs here and there. On the forest floor. You got to expect to see them, right? That's what they would be doing, is just falling all over the place. All right, this is still touching that other tree, so it's going to be slow to despawn. Come on, you. Get out of here. Go on. Go on now. Go on now. Oh, that's addictive, isn't it? You just stand there and you break them and break them and break them. Let's try a spruce back in here. There we go. There we go. Now we've got several. We got the fir, we got the pine, and we've got the spruce represented here. And then I think I want to do... Let's see. We've got the magic sapling here. Let's put you down here. No. Let's do this little orange one out front. What do I do with that bone meal? Oh, I used it all. Okay, compost. I said I had compost. Yes, I did. Let's do a little one of these right here. There we go. There we go. What is this? Oak, maple. That's a maple tree. Okay, beautiful. So we got a little bit maple. Let's do a small magic tree instead of a large one. Let's put a little one in here. A little bit of blue won't hurt anybody right in here. Maybe right here. There we go. Beautiful. And then another maple out front here, a small one. There we go. Now the blue one will look a little bit better from as we come up from this direction here. We'll have a path that goes down here to the tree farm. I think it'll probably cut right through here more than likely, and boom, we'll be right down into the tree farm area. So as we come back up, bam, we've got some nice color to look at. All right, so now, I'm getting real hungry here. There we go, beautiful. Okay, now we've got fern, cylindrical, oh, a cherry tree. That's right, I had a cherry tree. I want to put the cherry tree someplace up close here, near us. I think a cherry tree would do okay here. Let's put it right there. Let's do that right there. We'll just let that grow. And the Japanese maple, we've got, that's a Japanese maple right there. Now we need more green, though. We need more green. And the spruce is what I decided we were going to use for the green. Let's throw one here. We're going to throw one right here. And let's throw another one back here. And maybe one right here. And now we're dropping in elevation here. There's no snow up in this area, so it's definitely starting to lend itself to some warmer trees, I think. Let's go ahead and grab 10 more of those. Yeah. Let's do that. And we got us 30 bone meal. Come on. Grow up. There you go. That's it. You could be a short little tree. That's okay. There we go. Another short little one. And what else do we have here? We had a couple more, I think. There we go. And didn't I have another one? Just one more? Maybe not. Let's take a look back at our handiwork here as we continue our mountain lake tree, kind of tree show off area, right? We're kind of, look at that. Look at that orange one way up there. That's really cool. I love how that worked out. All those trees look really great back in there. So yeah, now we're getting into some shorter trees down in here. This is very good. Oh, here he is. You know what? That's not going to be a good place for you. You're going to just hide my cherry tree, and I don't want you doing that. All right, let's throw a few more of these sticks down. So, you can use these up. I made sure I kept a couple inside. Can you bone meal? No, you can't bone meal that. There we go. A little bit of color back in here. There we are. Excellent. Oh, there's a little flower. There's a poppy. And boom, boom. We got four left here. Oh, there we go. One more. One more. Let's throw it right there. Oh, that's looking really great. I love that. Okay, that's great. Let's go ahead and get some dirt. And I think what I want to do is fill this in. Let's do the best we can with what we got right here. Five more. There, that gives us a little bit more land out here to look at. Let's see, how are we doing? Oh yeah, this is great. This is great. Mm-hmm. Okay, the blueberries are starting to come in. You see the little bits of blue out there? That's nice. Cherry tree. Come on, cherry tree. Yeah, this is looking much better. Much better out here. It's coming alive. Oh, you know what else I had? I had a classic oak sapling. You've got to have an oak. You just got to have an oak. In Arizona, in the forest, in my forest, we got scrub oak. They're not the prettiest oak trees in the world, but they stand out and they all have this, they've got a personality to them. They almost look like Halloween trees, every single one of them, because they just grow so gnarly. and they're struck by lightning, and they've got these weird branches, and they, you know, some branches die off. And these oak trees have just got quite a personality to them. Maybe what we do is a little oak tree right down here. Let's do a little one. There we go, a little baby oak tree. Oh, I love that. I love that one there. Okay, that's perfect. Let's do another one. But let's put this one over on this side here. And we will put you right down here. A little baby oak tree. Perfect. Awesome. Let's take a look from down here at what we got going on. So we've got a viewpoint from each direction. Oh yeah, see, coming up the path here, right through here, that's going to be a nice little walk, huh? With that beautiful forest to our right. Lots of color in it. Yeah, I think so. I think that is going to be absolutely perfect. It's funny how this red one grows so much bigger than the yellow one, which you can't even see from here, but it's there. It's there. We have one more left. We have another one of those yellow ones left, so I probably should grow it and then get, get some more saplings from it. Because we found those. We didn't just see it. We didn't just find it growing somewhere. It was in a chest, this one here. This autumn. Goldenrod autumn leaves. It's a beautiful tree. It is really a beautiful tree. How does it look over on this side of it? This is all marble. Wow, look at all that marble. That is a ton of marble. Yeah, that's beautiful too. Okay, I love it. Okay, I love it. We've got this taken care of. Maybe what else do we have for trees on us? I don't want to plant the Japanese maple. I've changed my mind on that. Let's go ahead and add a few more spruce just as we get down to the bottom of the hill here. And we're going to make them little ones. That way, they just kind of fit. There we go. Beautiful. How's that look? Oh, awesome. Look at the yellow in there with that green. That is perfect. I love that. I love that a lot. Okay, that is perfect. Okay, boom, boom, boom. We're done with that. Wow, that went really fast. Oh, we've got these guys right here. This is going to give us a little bit of yellow in here. A little bit of yellowy green color. I think is going to be good. So let's do some of these. The more color, the better, I think. It just makes your eye wander around the whole place, you know? Oh, it's really jumpy back in here. That fir tree, I think, is really what's to blame for all of this. As I mention every time we come out here. A little bit of yellow there. We've got some yellow right in there, so that's good. Let's put one up here. And one in the back here. Sure, why not? Oh, I just destroyed one of our ferns that we put in. I tried to pick plants that I thought we found out in the colder climates. So I think I did a good job of picking them out. Okay, we've got that one there. We'll put one over these over here. One of these right over here. Okay, let's see how that... Those should look good once they grow up. And we have some boxwood bushes here. Let's throw these guys in. These are going to come up nicely in front of all the tree trunks and stuff and kind of blend in beautifully. Whoa, 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 whoa. Look at that. That's getting real bad there, isn't it? Let's throw a few of those in there. We'll clump that up a little bit. And we'll throw one there. And let's throw one down here. And we'll throw one right next to the tree. And let's do another one. I think the key to this is to just spread things out a little bit and just don't do one everywhere. You've got to, you know, sometimes you've got to throw a couple in, you know? You're trying to make it look like nature and, you know, nature's got a way of making itself look so beautiful. It's really hard to, I think, replicate that beauty, but I do the best I can. And there we go. We're kind of keeping it right to this edge. I don't want it spreading out into here. This is going to be a walkway with who knows what else we decide or what else comes to my imagination. And let's throw another one of these in right back there. There we go. Perfect. Now we've got to wait for all of that stuff to grow up. But look at the flowers and stuff coming in, huh? Really nice. Very, very nice. Oh my God, we are so low on the bones. Ooh. There for a while we had quite a few, and now they've really dropped off. This area is going to be kind of just to know, you just don't go back in here, you know? This is all for looks right through here. That blue flower was gorgeous. Look at this blue one here. What is this? Delphinium belladonna. Oh, that's beautiful. I love that one. Yeah, those guys are going to get nice. Okay, those only grow, they only have a couple stages in growth, but they will still come up and look really nice. Really nice. And then we're going to splash a little bit more. There we go. That's all we've got, huh? Okay. There it is. The forest. The GEI Fall Forest, huh? Yeah, that looks nice. So I suppose we should add a few more of the barriers and some more glowstone back in there so it has a bit of a glow to it, huh? I suppose we should do something like that. Yeah, we probably should. Okay, let's do that. Let's do that. Let's pick a few more potatoes while we're here. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. That gets us 16 potatoes. We'll throw these in the old furnace here. Boom, and off they go. And let's get some barriers and some glowstone dust. I may have glowstone dust on me. Let's see. I don't. Looks like I put it all away. That's okay. It gives us an excuse to run back to the GEI, down our beautiful walkway here with all the wonderful flowers and the big Japanese maple trees. My favorite tree, the Japanese maple. Mm-hmm. It's a pretty tree. I had a friend who had a great big one growing outside of his house, and it was just the prettiest tree. It had those maple-colored leaves year-round, and it was just gorgeous. In the winter, of course, it would lose them, but he had actually planted it on the side of the house that worked out really well for it. What was I down here for? Barriers. Carpenter barriers. How many of those do we have? 9, huh? Okay, so we need some more of those, and glowstone dust, and glowstone dust, is that what we got over here? Yes. Boom, we'll grab a stack of that. And I think we've got some sticks in here. We sure do. Beautiful. All right, let's make some more barriers. Barriers. I believe it's this and... yeah. 6 of them. There we go. Let's do that. How many does that get us? That gets us up to 33. That should be plenty to work with out here. I've got the cattails in my inventory because I thought we might work on that pond a little bit today, but I don't know that we're going to have time for that today, but we certainly can do some barriers and some glowstone dust. And then we were using pine logs on those, weren't we? I don't have any pine saplings anymore. I don't know what happened to them all, but I just don't seem to have any more. Do we have pine logs? Look at our wood chest now. They're starting to fill in a little bit with all kinds of different types of wood. This is pine. Let's grab a bunch of that. There we go. We'll just use those to cover up the carpenter barriers like we've been doing. The pine seems to work out pretty darn good. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, by the way, I changed out the map. The Easy Breezy Getaway is now on the map, as you can see there. Huh? You can see the palm tree right there on it. Yeah, Easy Breezy Getaway is now part of the GEI map. Beautiful. Awesome. Oh, what was this over here? Okay, that's the exit. That's just the kind of the farmland. You know what? I'm a little surprised the lake doesn't show up. You can see the trees, but the lake itself doesn't show up. I wonder why it wouldn't, because it's blue water. Maybe I need to add a couple more maps in here, don't I? Yeah, I think I do. I think I do. Uh-oh, I think the sun is going down too. I tell you what, I'm going to sleep. Okay, and then we'll go out and we'll add some lighting to our new chunk of forest. And then I will be right back. And we are back. Welcome back, everybody. I got my back turned so you guys can kind of see what I look at when I'm coming running out here like this. Huh? Look at that. That's pretty nice. Pretty dang awesome. Mm-hmm. So, it's going to sound kind of weird to you, but, you know, I'm kind of weird. We do not have a pumpkin seed anywhere on the property. Here at the GEI, we have no pumpkin seeds. Let me look in here real quick. No. Uh-uh. No pumpkin seeds. We need pumpkins. We need to do a little decorating for Halloween. I mean, it's coming up, right? It's October, and it's Halloween month, and so we need to do some decorating, and we don't have any pumpkins. I have none out here, which is so weird to me. I don't know why. I just don't. We can get rid of the axe, I think, for now, and we need these guys right here. Boom, there we go. So I think we're going to go off on a little quest next episode, our Friday episode. We're going to take a little stroll out and about and see if we can't find pumpkins. I need some seeds. I looked everywhere. I thought we had pumpkin seeds over here, but we don't. We don't have any, which is so bizarre to me. And what brought that to my attention this week was I saw a story that came across my desk out of Northern California. A third grade teacher there, and I've got this in front of me here, so I'm going to probably pause a little bit here every now and again, take a look at it. Out of Washington State, she's a teacher in Washington State. Her name is Cindy Tobeck. Cindy entered the Northern California pumpkin growing contest. She grew a pumpkin that weighed 1,910 pounds. Unbelievable. That is how much her pumpkin weighed. Can you believe that? And she won. That was the winning weight. She won $11,500 in prize money. She's being paid $6 per pound for this pumpkin. 1,910 pounds. We put these back behind the trees so you don't see them. Like so. So you see the glow, but you don't see the posts. Hopefully. Hopefully that's the case. Oh, watch it, watch it, watch it. We'll do one right in here. Like so. There we go. And I think we're going to add one more. We got one right there, huh? Okay, so we probably got enough light there. Let's go ahead and put one right underneath here. Like so. There we go. 1,910-pound pumpkin. She says it took her, she planted the pumpkin in April of 2016, this year, and she grew it in a greenhouse with heated soil. Now that is showing a pumpkin some serious love. Heated soil for the pumpkin. I'm just checking to see if we need any more of these back in here. So far it looks pretty good. Perhaps maybe, okay, we got one right there. I'm thinking maybe one right here. Right there. Way in the back. Yeah, that's going to send a nice glow off in this direction here, too. So now we just have to wait for the sun to go down. This cherry tree, man, it ain't growing. What's up, cherry tree? Come on, man. What else? Okay, we've got one there. We've got one there. I think we're pretty well lit up. I would have to say we're probably pretty well lit up. Yeah. Okay, that's good for that. That is very good for that, I think. Now we just have to wait for the sun to go down. Last year's winning pumpkin, the seed that she used this year to grow her 1,910-pound pumpkin, she received from a pumpkin that won the competition last year, and that pumpkin weighed 2,230 pounds. Can you believe that? 2,230 pounds was the winning pumpkin from last year. The runner-up this year for the giant pumpkin contest weighed... where is that one at on here? It was 1,723 pounds. Can you imagine that? I mean, try to picture a pumpkin that big. But we have no pumpkin seeds. Zero pumpkin seeds here at the GEI. So we need to go off and find some pumpkin seeds. And I think maybe over into this forest area right here, go off in that direction right there. I feel like that's the lucky direction to go, right over there. We've passed pumpkins. In all of our explorations, we've seen them. It's like, oh, look, there's some pumpkins. There's some pumpkins. But never have we grabbed any of the pumpkins, so we need to do that. While we're waiting for the sun to go down and kind of check the lighting here out here, let's see. Do we have any more? We've got a little more bones. Let's do three more. Oh, my God. We're getting so low on the bones now. We're going to have to get that mob grinder going. I want this cherry tree to grow. There we go. Oh, that's a nice cherry tree. What do we got on here for cherries? One, two, three. Only three. One, two, three. Looks like only three, maybe four cherries on here. At least three. That's okay. That works. That'll work. It's in a good little spot. And then we're going to put... No, we can't put that there. That looks ridiculous. Can't have that there. Nuh-uh. Oh, and then the water's not working right. All right. Anytime you mess with the water out here, you gotta fix it, especially along the shoreline, it seems like. Oh, the sun is going down. Okay. So we know right now that we want to have a path as we come out of the GEI. We're going to come out here, and we're going to turn out and go down this way. Okay, we're going to have a staircase right here. Bum, bum, bum. Down it goes. Straight across here. Bump, drops right here through this little valley, and down we go into that valley right there, and that's where we got our tree farm. So that's going to be a perfect little path. I think so. I think it's going to be a really good path. All right, let's take a look at our mountain lake forest. Don't you love naming things? I do. I love naming things. We've got some dirt. Maybe we could pill. Nope. Cancel. Get out of here. Get out of there. We got some dirt right here. Let's see. Oh, there it is. Look at that. Can you guys see that okay? I hope you can see that okay. If I Z, what does that do? That pulls us way in too close. But now we've got ourselves a nice forest that stretches from right up there all the way down along the shoreline and down heading towards our tree farm area. Lovely. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. I've got to say goodbye. I'm sorry. That's all the time I've got. You know, it just took me a long time to get everything filled in, but dang it, we did it. We can move forward now. I'm really excited about this. Very, very excited about this. So, if you enjoyed today's episode, I sure would appreciate it if you could hit that like button for me, comment, subscribe, and share. I'm the Radio Man 03. Have an awesome, fantastic, and superb day, and I look forward to talking to you again next time.